Calm down, Tony. It's not a problem, mate. White is hot.
Red is warm and blue is cold. Yeah, look, it's simple.
Look, point the thing at your face, yeah? It's infrared. It picks up your face. Go on. Open your mouth.
That's white. My mouth is hot, obviously. Ears are blue, big and cold. And my nose there, it's red.
You as well. Good man. See, it's simple, isn't it? Lovely. All right, love to the kids. See you soon. Ciao for now. Bye-bye. Later. Now then, work to be done. Let's see what we've got here.
Oh, yes, look at that. Cracked panes, music to my eyes.
Lots of dosh to be made here for the discerning double-glazing salesman with a gift at a gap.
All right, Gov, how you doing?
Steve Gizzybo's the name. Uh-huh. Leading energy consultant with General Energy Efficiency Systems, Europe Registered, or Giza for short. Know what I mean? I've been conducting a little bit of research down your street with my natty little infrared camera here, and I'm sorry to say that your house has come out the worst.
What?
Oh, yes. In terms of energy efficiency, it's not happening. Nope, you've got more hot air coming out of this place than a day in Parliament. Know what I mean? No worries, though. I'll sort you out, Gov, for a couple of ponies.
Well, I'm interested in saving a few pennies. Yeah, well, come inside.
Lovely. Thanks. Come on up and in. Nice place. Oh, yes. It's a bit cold in here, mate.
Well, that's why I'm wearing my hat. Got to wrap up warm in old houses like this, you know.
Not a problem. I'll soon have you sorted out. Mind if I have a look upstairs?
Absolutely.
Last one. Cheers. Oh, yes. Very nice indeed. Here, you've got some nice old bits and pieces, mate. Tell you what, I've got a mate. Take this away a lot for you for a tenner.
I've spent years buying this furniture. Same sort of age of the house, almost 300 years old, you know. A lot of this old furniture has a very particular purpose. This chair, for example, sit down here. These wings protect you from the draft coming through the window here. And a day like this, you know, chilly, it's a great place to sit by the fire, having a crumpet. I mean, do you want one?
Lovely. Well, sit down, Gav. Nice one. Cheers.
Oh. No. What, careful, it's old fabric, huh? But this won't take long. Nice hot fire.
Anyway, let's get down to business. It's a lovely old place, but you're doing a very good job of heating the street, if you know what I mean. You see, heat transfers from a hot area to a cold area thanks to three processes: convection, conduction, and radiation. I can demonstrate conduction very well with this little poker here. If I pop it in the fire there, heat transfers from one end to the other thanks to conduction.
With infrared time-lapse, we can see thermal energy being transferred from tip to handle by conduction.
Now then, if you want your place to remain nice and toasty all the time, you've got to find a way of stopping the heat from in here transferring to out there. Let me have a look. Do you want the good news or the bad news?
Good news.
The good news is that glass is not a very good conductor of heat. The bad news is you've got a lot of it. And with all that surface area, it's not long before it's all gone outside.
These four rods are made of copper, steel, glass and wood. This infrared image shows what happens when the rods are heated from the bottom. The progression of the red and white colours shows how quickly energy is transferred by conduction. Even though glass is a poor conductor of heat compared to steel and copper, a lot of heat can be lost through windows because they have a large surface area.
But that's the least of your troubles. You've also got to worry about convection. The best way to demonstrate that is to light this little Victorian brass angel thingy. If I light these candles, they'll start to create convection currents. As the hot air rises, the fan blades at the top start to turn, and with them, the angels about their merry dance.
This infrared sequence shows hot air rising over a radiator.
And it's exactly the same in your house. The hot air is bombing around through convection, and it's not long before it finds holes in your windows and cracks, and it's outside. You've lost it. The only way to deal with all that heat loss thanks to convection and conduction is with double glazing.
That's all very well and good, but I already have double glazing. These shutters trap hot air between the glass and their edge here. And also, they're darn sight better looking sort of stuff you want to sell me.
The wooden shutters prevent the warm air in the room from coming into contact with the glass, so heat loss through the windows is minimised. The trapped air is a good insulator.
That's not double glazing, look! It's wood! It doesn't even fit properly and it's brown! Therefore, You need some double glazing.
No, I don't want double glazing. Look, I know what you're saying, but I can't rip out those windows. They're nearly 300 years old.
Rip them out! Chuck some PVC in there. Look, there's a third way in which you're losing heat. Radiation. If I use my infrared camera, I can show you. Look, I point the camera at the fire. It's white. That's because it's hot. But if I put my hand between the fire and the lens, it's black. White, black. It's quite simple. The radiation is moving at the speed of light. Therefore, it's almost instant.
Look, I know all about radiation. 200 years ago, this house was heated by radiation. Look, this cannonball out of the fire, they would carry this around from room to room. It radiates heat. This fireplace is pretty simple, not much metal there. Downstairs, the fireplace is full of iron, and that radiates heat. It's more economic than double glazing.
The hot cannonball was the 18th century equivalent of the mobile radiator.
This is what I wanted to show you. Now look, this fireplace, the grate here, was put in a lot later than the one upstairs, and it's much more effective. The cannonball sits there very happily. It's made of cast iron, so it radiates heat. It's very efficient indeed.
All the extra iron in this fireplace is helping to radiate energy into the room.
It might be efficient, but let's face it, it's not UPVC efficient. Grab that little tester, I'll even do you a good deal.
This is an absolute dead loss, isn't it?
No. Okay, look, great. No. Hey, how about a heater bin dead loss? No, I've got some plastic substitutes. Yeah. I bought them up for a fiver. Oh. Hi, Tony Blair is the name. And selling houses is my game. My philosophy is simple. If you can live in it, I can sell it. Take this delightful Oxford Street, for example. Houses, mainly post-war, semi-detached, big, spacious and expensive. A bit like my company car. I'm off to do some business at number 26. Why don't you tag along? At first glance, it doesn't look particularly interesting, but take a closer peek and it's got some very natty features. There's the car of Italian design, apparently nicknamed Hannibal, on account it crossed the Alps to win the European Solar Car of the Year award. Smashing. Almost as natty as this little infrared camera here. Bought it off my cousin Steve. Now, let's see what we're looking at. Look at that, superb. Hardly any heat escaping from the roof, windows and doors. Compare that to the house next door.
You must be the estate agent. Come in.
Absolutely. Hi. Lovely. Oh, nice car. Nice to see you. May I? Thanks. So look what we've got in here then. Oh, yes. What a beautiful sitting room and all that lovely, gorgeous sunlight.
Well, it doesn't only look nice, but it saves me money as well.
What, just the sunlight?
Well, there's the stove as well.
Let's have a look.
The secret about this stove is that it's got very high thermal mass, which basically means that when I light the fire in here, all that heat is absorbed in the concrete that it's made of. That concrete absorbs the heat and stores it, so even when the fire goes out, it's still re-radiating heat to heat the whole house.
This is an infrared picture of the stove soon after it has been lit. It heats up very slowly because of its high thermal mass. It takes about 2 hours to reach its highest temperature. Because the concrete bricks store heat very efficiently, the stove is still radiating heat a couple of hours after the fire has gone out.
What about this BU little skirt number above the fireplace?
Well, this fire not only heats this room, but it heats the rest of the house as well. And how it does that is that all the hot air that gathers around the stove rises, because hot air rises, and collects inside this skirt. But all that hot air then moves next door to heat the room next door by convection.
Okay, so you've got all that lovely heat, but what stops it from escaping through the walls?
Well, you're right. The walls and the floors and the ceilings are all made of concrete in this house, so that acts a bit like the thermal mass in the stove. But around that, the whole house is super insulated, so you've got a sort of overcoat of insulation, and then you keep the rain and the wind out with the bricks on the outside.
The walls of this house are made of three layers, each with its own specific job. The thick inside wall is made of very dense concrete, which stores heat and re-radiates it in a similar way to the stove. Behind the concrete layer, there is a cavity filled with fibre, which helps to insulate the inner wall by trapping air. And on the outside, there are normal bricks, which help to keep the heat in. The roof is also well insulated. Underneath the roof tiles is a thick layer of fibre wool.
What about the windows, though? Because I know they're very likely to let heat out through them.
Yeah, not through these windows, mate. Look, they're triple glazed.
Look at that.
You see, it's made of three panes of glass, so you've got two panes here and one pane there, and it's got a layer of air in the middle, so not only does this window let the sunlight in, radiate through the glass, but that air acts as insulation inside it.
Good stuff. Triple glazing, that means triple the commission.
Double or triple glazing is a good way of reducing heat loss. In double glazing, air is trapped between the panes. Air is a good insulator, reducing the transfer of thermal energy from one pane to another. With triple glazing, the extra sandwich of air increases efficiency.
Hey, Doc, you going to chuck this antique in with a sail?
That's not an antique. That's what I measure the temperatures with. Look, you can see over a week, the temperature in this house doesn't vary more than a degree or two, except when I have parties. Look, that's one for 50 people.
Well, that little bump there's a party. Must have been a good night. Anyway, Doc, you measure the temperature. I'll go measure your bits and pieces. Plant, nice touch. Oh yeah, the patio is good for a barbie. Nice big garden. Oh dear, what's going on with the roof?
Well, that roof is a really important part of the house because you see the 38 solar electric panels there. They actually generate more electricity than the house uses over the year. Then you've got the solar hot water systems and you've got the sun space which heats the house. So all in all, we use very little fossil fuels in this house, which means it's very good for the environment.
Great. Balcony next.
Right, come through and see the sun space. I'm particularly proud of this.
Oh, yes, lovely.
There's a great thing to this balcony, like the wood effect as well, very Scandinavian.
Yeah, but it's not just how it looks that matters, because this sun space actually is the biggest source of heat in the whole house. You see, in winter, when the sun rises over there and sets over there, you've got the sunshine in this space all day. And that goes to create the heat that we use in the house. It's a bit like a greenhouse.
So how does her greenhouse stay warm even in the depths of winter? Infrared radiation from the sun warms the earth. This heats the air above it, which then rises by convection. Cool air moves in to take its place. If we build a greenhouse, the warm air that rises is trapped inside it. Convection currents are set up inside the greenhouse. The temperature climbs as the air is repeatedly warmed up by the ground and is not replaced with fresh supplies of cool air.
But in summer, when the sun rises behind you and sets behind me, the high sun angle means that you don't actually get any direct sunshine into the house, so that stays cool. And even if it does get too hot in the summer, it's quite simple. We just open these windows and all that hot air is lost by convection.
Convection. Remind me to put that on the brief. Lovely. Well, I'll be in touch with you about the details. Incidentally, why are you selling the place?
Oh, I'm designing another one, only this time it's going to have a solar heated swimming pool.
Good grief. Smart for some. Anyway, Doctor, thanks for your time.
Bye. Cheers.
I've got to be absolutely honest. I was never going to make my fortune in the keeping it warm business, so I thought I'd try my hand keeping it cool. Come on, ladies and gentlemen, cold drinks, let my partner Paul prepare a nice fruit cocktail for you. How you doing, madam?
All right, thanks. A little bit sunburnt.
You are a bit on the roof side, aren't you? You know what you need to be doing? stopping the UVAs and the UVBs from the sun from reaching your skin. And it's a great way to do it. Do what the locals do, wear white. There's a nice white t-shirt for you. How about this lovely white hat?
Mm-hmm, that looks great.
That'll go with your t-shirt. And then to finish the whole outfit off, try a nice big white umbrella, like mine.
Yeah,
it helps to stop those rays from touching you.
Keeping the sun's rays off our skin is important for two reasons. It keeps us cool and safe. Energy from the sun reaches the Earth in the form of electromagnetic radiation. It travels through space at the speed of light. This radiation includes visible light, infrared, and ultraviolet. Infrared radiation warms us up. Ultraviolet, in the form of UVA and UVB, causes us to tan. Ultraviolet can also cause premature aging and skin cancer.
$20,000 for you.
A bit steep, $10,000.
Oh, go on, $7,000. Love it. Thanks a lot.
Bye.
Look out for that starfish. Yasoo!
A white umbrella will reflect more radiant energy from the sun than a black umbrella. On this infrared camera, white is hot and blue is cold. We can see that the black umbrella is letting through more thermal energy. The white umbrella is reflecting more of the sun's radiation, so the person underneath feels cooler. In hot Mediterranean countries, buildings are often white outside so that the radiant energy from the sun is reflected, keeping the inside of the house cool.
Here's a natty little idea I got from one of the locals. I also got a brilliant recipe for a salad, but I'll talk about that later. How do you think people in hot Mediterranean countries used to keep their water cool before the invention of the fridge? Well, it's one of these little fellas. It's a simple, unglazed, earthenware pot. And it keeps the water inside cool in the same way that my body is keeping me cool. They both sweat. When I sweat, the heat from my body causes the water on my skin to evaporate.
When we get hot, we sweat. Our sweat contains water, which evaporates to produce water vapor. Evaporation requires a lot of energy. As our skin warms up, our pores release water. Some of the water evaporates because the more energetic water molecules escape. This evaporation requires energy which comes from the skin, so the skin cools down.
And it's exactly the same for this pot. You see on the outside there's a thin film of water. Well, when that water evaporates, it takes with it the heat from the inside of the pot, leaving the water nice and cool.
Water molecules seep through the pores of the pot. Again, some of the water evaporates. The energy needed to turn the liquid into vapor comes from the pot, so evaporation cools down the pot.
And I can prove it with this rather natty electronic thermometer. I've left this glazed mug of water here for the same time as the water in the jug. And as you'll see from my reading, it's an even 23.1 Celsius. If I did the same with the water in the pot, then hey presto, 18.9 Celsius. You see, it works. Not only am I looking good, but I'm keeping cool. All I've got to do is sort out this damp problem. Cheers.